Well, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
So my name is Mary Lyons Kim, and I'm from ITN, North Jersey. We are a Wyckoff-based nonprofit. We drive senior citizens and the visually impaired. And this June, we will be 3 years old. Last October, we had our very first fundraiser. John Adams came, and it was a wine tasting, and we held it in a little church in Hohokus, and it was a really warm, great success. So we're looking forward to doing something different this year, maybe something in a brewery or something. John, I think, is going to introduce me to someone who may give us some suggestions. So, and we really appreciate the support of the Wyckoff Midland Park Rotary. It's just such a perfect fit, I think, because there's so much generosity of spirit here. And what we do is we have 99 volunteer drivers. Our next one will be the 100th. We're going to post on Facebook, and it's a big deal. Balloons and so on and so forth.
Can you hold the microphone?
Is it on?
Like this one?
That's good.
That's okay. Dr. Orr, my 23-year-old son, seeing you just reminds me when I was at Coolidge, Dr. Shupp was the principal then, Joanne Zellers and I would do cultural assemblies, and it just throws me back. My gosh, time goes so fast. I love those days. I absolutely love those school days. So, I was thinking this morning driving over here, our two newest members, that's what we call our riders. One is a lady from Whitehall. She now lives in over by the Y. Spring Meadow. She raised her kids here in Wyckoff. Her husband had worked for IBM, that's what brought them over here. And she's a widow now, and she's got great grandchildren and so on. And so her adult kids said, you know, you've just got to stop driving. And so she is finally kind of transitioning. And every Friday she needs an appointment to the doctor over on Franklin Turnpike. So last week we took her for the first time. No, we've taken her two different Fridays. And she was so nervous the first time because who are we? And you know, she sits right in the front with us. We chit chat about, you know, was Easter coming up and that kind of thing. And the second week she was like, oh hi! You know, I feel so much much more comfortable than I thought I would. I was telling my sons, everybody's so nice and so on and so on. I said it is. It's a safer way to go. This lady shouldn't be driving at all. And her kids really want to take the car away, but she's just fighting it. And we can understand that. It's human nature. I'm just putting myself, you know, in the future. That's the last thing I would want to do. Our other new member that started also 2 weeks ago, or she started last week, she moved here from Westchester. Her daughter is, you probably know her daughter, Dr. Orr, from the Lincoln School District. And yes. So her mother just moved here to a little apartment in Midland Park because she needed to be closer to her daughter and so on. And she was also nervous the first time. So I think I took her on the
return.
Hmm? She doesn't live there. Yeah, she lives right. Yeah, not too far. So she, the first day, she went to the Midland Park Library, and then she spent an hour and a half, and then went home. The next day, she went to the Stop and Shop. So, and I took her home from the Stop and Shop visit. And so she calls about an hour later, and she said, "Hi," and I figured she's calling to make an appointment for this coming week. She said, "I just want to call to say I just can't believe this happened. That I was able to go to the library and just relax. I was able to do my grocery shopping." She said, "I'm just calling to thank you. And on Good Friday, you came out and you know, you drove us and so on." I said, "It's our pleasure. This is what we want to do." So then she called back yesterday and she said, "Well, Thursday, can I go to the Wyckoff Library? And then can I go to Interstate? Isn't that where the ShopRite is, I hear, on Friday?" And this is what we do. It's like medical appointments. This lady who needs to have a doctor every, she goes to a hematologist every single Friday. Something kind of life-saving to the quality of life issues, like just being able to go into the library or get your hair done. Attend the Midland Park Seniors is absolutely terrific. It's the best county-supported senior center in Bergen County. And it's just, we take a man who lives with his daughter in Hohokus there. Every Thursday, there's a special program for the profoundly deaf. And they have people come from different counties, even as far away as Morris and Sussex, to attend. But we bring him every week. And that's such an important social connection for him. So that's really who we are, what we do. We offer arm-through-arm, door-through-door service. We have, I've lost track of how many. We've driven close to 100,000 miles. It's just been incredible. And we work out of our homes, or, you know, people say, where's your office exactly? And I'm like, here's my phone. Here's where it is. We work remotely. We thought we'd have a brick-and-mortar office, but we're out busy driving all the time, or, you know, doing things like this. And so we end up just working remotely out of our, you know, Wyckoff kitchens and so on. So, and I just thank you for the support. This is the second time I've been invited back. It's one of my favorite things. I was all happy this morning to get going, and then I had a phone call. I had to take care of before I go here. But anyway, we just really are grateful for your support, and thank you so much. If you know, the important thing for us is always recruiting volunteer drivers. We ask for only one ride a month, and it's like a one-way trip. So it could be taking, you know, Lorraine to the library, or to the, if she wants to go to the post, she'll be doing other things, banking, post office, things like that. And then you just see all the rides that are available, and you just put your name in. Oh, I can do this morning, or you know, next Saturday, or whatever it might be. We have people that do go to church on Sundays. So anyway, think about it. If you know someone where this would be the right fit, all of us volunteer. For some people, what we do is what interests them, or it's just the right fit for them. So if you know someone who's interested in just, all we ask is just, like I say, just that one ride a month, just let me know, okay? I've got cards with me. And the name of our organization, ITN North Jersey, is cumbersome. We are the New Jersey affiliate of ITN America, which is based up in Portland, Maine. So it's a cumbersome name. We didn't pick it, but people think we're an IT company, but it's Independent Transportation Network. That's what it stands for. Yes.
Mary, so obviously the drivers use their own cars.
Yes, we do.
Any insurance? Do you provide any insurance, or is it just?
Well, the insurance we provide is the umbrella liability policy. Okay. So we offer the arm-through-arm, door-through-door. So far, so good. But if someone were to trip or something were to happen, that's where our umbrella liability policy comes in. I have New Jersey Manufacturers Insurance, and, you know, so they actually gave us a small grant, because they were waiting for IT in America for someone to open up in New Jersey, because we get people off the road who shouldn't be driving. Yeah. And, you know, I was thinking the other day, I was talking to someone about this, and, you know, we think about it's my mother, it's you know, maybe my grandmother or something.
Oh,
but yes, and yeah. It's us.
It's gonna be us eventually.
It really is. And there's going to be a point where we can't drive, and we're going to be wanting to attend, you know, Rotary meetings, or, you know, be able to get to the doctor and not have our daughter have to leave work every time that, you know, you need to go to the dentist or things like that. That's one of the nice things we hear is, you know, so it's a way of, like, kind of giving forward to, you know, yeah.
Other than a drive.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. Okay. Insurance. And so your auto insurance covers you, because
yep.
That's the state of New Jersey, yep. The law that you're covered. We always tell people, call your auto insurance, let them know that you're going to be a volunteer driver for ITN North Jersey. And
they usually know it.
They know it. It's like, okay, Progressive, you know, all the different.
Are they always local drives? Are they always local drives?
They're often local drives, but they're within the county. So we do have some people, you know, we have a waiting list, East of Route 17, because we don't have enough drivers there. I also want to say, I don't know why, but I'm very grateful that in Northwest Bergen is where we have most of our drivers, and it's not all because we're based in Wyckoff, because we'll get some press that, let's say, from the Record, the Road Warrior column, and it goes all over the county, and then someone will say, oh, I saw something in the Road Warrior, or I saw something from Bergen Volunteer Center. And where are they from? They're from here.
Yeah, because most people here not walk our road.
No, but even in the Pascack Valley, I'm not getting as many drivers.
Really?
Yeah, and definitely I need drivers in the whole Fort Lee, Englewood, Teaneck area. We have a couple of drivers over there, but we really, you know, so to answer your question, we do have members that might have, that might live in Wyckoff, but here and there have a doctor on Cedar Lane, things like that. So you pick what you want. That's the thing. Some people are like, I don't mind doing that. I love driving, and it's a good time of the day for me, so I'll go ahead and take that drive. But frankly, the truth is that John Boswick, Kate Surgent, and I, who run this organization, we do most of those longer trips because, you know, drivers don't typically pick them, which is absolutely fine. So even those little short, little local trips, we love having those taken because then we can really focus on those other ones that take, you know, a little more time.
So Mary, what happens is somebody signs up to be a volunteer.
Yes.
They go onto your website and they see where.
Very easy to go onto the website. To sign up, first of all, you can peruse the website. It gives a better feeling for who we are, I think, even than what I'm saying here. So then there's an online, very quick background check. It's very, very quick. But it's a vulnerable population we've got. So we've got to check your driver's license, you know, criminal history, sexual assault. Those three things are what we check for. And then you sit at my dining room table and get trained. And it's a PowerPoint on my little computer for maybe an hour, the most. And then you're off, and then you're put in the system by the end of that day. And then you can log on and you say, oh, this is what's available for this coming week. We send a big email out every Saturday and then a couple during the week. We sometimes send what we call pickle alerts, and that means, you know, we have four rides. John, Kate, and I are all driving, and we have that fourth ride, and it's not covered. And that fourth ride could be whatever, a volunteer. We have never had any, you know, no response to that. And we only put it out when it was, oh no, what are we gonna do? We're gonna have to send a pickle. And so it's been incredible. And we get so much feedback from the drivers about how rewarding it is. And did you know about, you know, because of life histories. I mean, it's really incredible what we hear from people in their lives. And they just seem like a quiet little lady and so on. And then you hear, like, you did that, and you were there, and this is where you came. It's very, very rewarding. So, and we hear there's a lot of funny things happen too.
Excellent.
Yeah. The people we drive, it's a membership. So they pay $90 a year, and then it's $1.50 a mile. Because we have to be sustainable. But we also have what we call a scholarship program. So if someone had trouble with that, then we would help them out. Like there's one lady in Mahwah, she goes to dialysis three times a week in Fairlawn. That's a long ride, and she's really on a very fixed income. So it's helped out. And also the volunteer drivers get, oh my gosh, is it 30 or 40 cents a mile? And they can take it, they can get a quarterly check, or they can donate it back to us for, sometimes they'll earmark, can you give it to, you know, Mrs. Smith? Something like that, you know, just give my mileage to her or to the general pool, and then we, you know, we can see who needs something. This one lady, she lives in Teaneck and she drives quite a bit. She's helping this lady in Mahwah. She's never even met her. She said, who do you think needs it the most? We said, well, we do have someone. And she says, yeah, I want my mileage to go to her. Nice. Or you could save it for when you think you might need it for your account.
Okay, that's what you're...
And there's no tipping, no money ever changes hands in the car. It's typically the adult child that sponsors the account. I don't know, everyone always says, oh, really, that's all it is? It's like, it's bare minimum, you know. We just have to cover our costs. Yeah, I know, yes, I know.
Good luck to you.
Yeah, it took 3 years to get up and running, so yeah. It's like, people are like, what are you doing? Did you ever do that? But it took a long time, so, okay. Thank you so much.